Look, it doesn't hurt. Okay, I'll tell a lie. It doesn't hurt if the water's cold and then you heat it up slowly.
You're using the torturing method?
Well, close your eyes for 30 seconds. It'll be all over.
No.
Tanya.
And give me the crayfish. No, walk away from the pot.
Well, even in the flash restaurants, they still have to kill the cray.
I know, but this is my kitchen, and I have to eat my muesli here in the morning, and how can I do that if I know this poor, defenseless creature was boiled alive? Thank you. Suppose you think I'm a ditz now.
No, I think I'm very hungry, and I think I've completely ruined your evening.
Mum's meat and potato soup. Mum's spaghetti bolognese. Yes! Fish fingers.
Yes.
Oh, when you said you were going to nuke my dinner.
It's not funny, Dad. I nearly called the fire service.
Flames?
No.
You were right?
I tried to call you.
At work?
On your cell phone.
Well, I had it turned off. You know, it makes the equipment play up.
Well, why didn't you check your messages? They left like 3.
Look, it must still be at work. I'm sorry. You're right, I should have checked.
I just wanted everything to be perfect. And now you'll be starving, so you're gonna have to get takeaways.
Hey, look, don't worry about me. Did you eat before the inferno?
Yeah.
Well, go on, you go to bed. I'll clean this mess up.
No, well, I did it.
Go on. Go to bed. Craig.
No, that's one of our doctors. How about Charlie?
I like Chucky better.
Okay, to Chucky, the lucky crayfish.
Hello, what are we going to do with him?
Leave him in the bath for now.
I could always take him back to the shop, get my money back.
I thought you said your mate caught him.
Not very impressive to say I got him from the fish mart.
Shall I put the jug on?
I thought I'd take you out for coffee and cake. You have earned it.
Well, I'm happy here.
Fine by me. Am I allowed to ask?
About?
That guy you dumped.
Moved on, finally.
You were pretty sad for a while, eh? Such a waste of your gorgeous smile. So are you back on the market?
Excuse me?
Sorry. You know what I mean. It's just, you know, last time was a bit of a fizzer, and I've always liked you, Tanya. Right from the start.
You know.
I don't want to rush you.
You're not. Back on the market?
I said sorry.
2 more shots as punishment, I think.
I worry about you.
I am fine. Truly. I'm even looking at buying a house. Well, an apartment. He should help me choose.
I'd like that. But Dad's pretty unhappy, though. So maybe you shouldn't rush into things.
Scarlett, we're not getting back together, not now.
But you should see him for yourself. He's really missing you.
Really?
Yeah, I even tried to cook him dinner last night to cheer him up, but it turned into a bit of a disaster.
Details?
Well, I managed to burn the food and then nearly burnt down the house. It was panic city. I totally freaked out.
Who was Craig?
At work.
Last night?
Yeah, he got caught into some emergency. You didn't hear about it?
No.
I didn't expect to see you lot today.
Oh, good night's sleep and he's right as rain.
Glad to hear it.
Yeah, off you go. Just easy passes and stay close, okay?
Yes, Dad.
I seriously didn't expect to see you. I hope you don't think I'm some sort of stalker or something.
Thanks for helping us out yesterday. Otherwise, it would have been midnight by the time they got to us.
Anyone would have done the same.
Sorry I was a bit short with you.
There's no need to apologise to me.
Your daughter told me that you'd had a rough time of it lately.
You were worried about Pete. Father's prerogative.
Watch me!
Nothing wrong with him.
I should have seen him yesterday.
There was heaps of blood.
Yeah, he was very brave, weren't you, Tiger?
No, he wasn't.
Hello.
Oh, sorry. My mother, Bonnie Flynn, and my dad, Gordon. This is Yvonne.
Yvonne's fine. How do you do?
Yvonne was a godsend yesterday. He even got Pete bumped up the queue.
I better get back. Nice to meet you.
Likewise.
How many stitches did you get?
Claire, have you seen my watch?
And?
Never mind.
Gonna be late.
Yeah, just a sec.
You've reached the home of Craig, Julia and Scarlett. If it's urgent, try our mobiles. Otherwise, leave a message.
It's an old message, don't you think? It's time for a new one.
Anyway, hi, Craig. It's me, Sarah. I'm just ringing to let you know that you left your phone behind. But I'll bring it into work with me. Cheers.
So, swap the order of those two and trim the intro to bring it down to one page.
Yep, otherwise all good.
Well, I'll make the adjustments and get it through to the printers. How's the head?
I am never drinking with you again.
Pick you up at 7.
Don't be late.
Can I have a word?
Sure, what's up?
In private.
I've got a break in a couple of hours. Can I wait till then?
You go, Craig. We can cover.
It's fine. We'll catch up later.
You're a liar, a coward, and a total pig. You didn't even tell me. I had to find out on the answer phone.
Scarlett, come upstairs.
No, don't you defend him. He doesn't deserve it.
Come on, Scarlett, let's go.
You said you're at work, and all that time you were with her.
Scarlett, I'm sorry.
Don't you dare talk to me. It's your fault that Dad and Hilliard broke up. You couldn't keep your hands to yourself. You're a bitch, a selfish, homewrecking bitch.